third quarter to secure their win over Fanshawe. Jalen Morgan dropped a 24-point all-team high. And this is they're going to be their looking for their 12th consecutive win. Jalen Morgan is en route to going to be the Humbers' all-time All-Canadian since 2004. Now over to you guys, Adam and Andrew.
Thank you, Caitlin, sideline reporter for today. Nice work. And she touched on Jalen Morgan there, Andrew, and this offense has really lived or died with that big man so far this year. He's been on an absolute tear as of late.
Yeah, and it really begins with that 40-point game he had right here last week. Was in at 38 until those final few seconds that he was going for 40. Can't blame him. Only the third time in program history someone's gone for that point total. And like Caitlin said, he's making a serious push for All-Canadian and well-deserved, if I do say so.
Well, he certainly got my vote, bias or not. Jalen Morgan averaging 28 points over his last three games. And these Hawks are riding high, an 11-game win streak for them. And you see where that puts them in the standings. Right up there with the likes of St. Clair and Sheridan. Niagara kind of bring it up the rear, but should be a decent test for the Hawks here tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. No team in this OCAA West Division is a complete walkover, so a game here in the Hawks, yes or not, is going to be a test, and we'll see what version of the Hawks shows up here tonight.
Absolutely. Trying to stretch that streak to an even dozen of the Hawks here tonight. Started their year 0-4. Have come out flying 11-0 in their last 11. As we meet the starters for the Niagara Knights. And with your Hawks, here they come. Circled Hilton on the roster. That's the man they'll be trying to slow down. Fists in the air for the Hawks, just moments away from tip-off. The usual suspects taking the floor. Muhammad, Francis, Kaskar, Samuels, and Morgan, your starters.
No surprises here.
Thumbs up all around. We're just about ready for tip-off here.
Last time these two teams met, Humber beat Niagara 95-88 in overtime. A 21-10 run in 6 minutes led by Khalidi Ismail was a big part of pushing them there. Of course, he won't be playing here tonight. And then Fauzi Muhammad each had 22 points in that victory.
Fauzi and Jalen, the two newest members of the 500-point club for the Hawks. A little bit of a delay with a jersey malfunction. Johnny Richardson trying to get that thing tucked in. And with everybody looking their best, we're ready for tip-off. And we are underway from the Hawks' nest. First possession goes to the Knights. And in a show of respect here, they'll run out the 24-second shot clock in honor of Kobe Bryant. who tragically lost his life just a few days ago in a helicopter crash, along with his daughter Gianna Bryant and seven others. Andrew, this is a tribute we've seen throughout the NBA over the past week, and it's nice to see the same here on the OCAA floor.
Yeah, certainly the classy move. I was wondering myself before the game if they were going to do this, and obviously they are, so nice move here. I'm sure Humber's going to reciprocate here themselves with the same move.
A nice gesture by the Knights. Jalen just going to hold on to this one. The Hawks faithful clapping it up. This one's for you, Kobe.
I could say almost, knowing for sure that Kobe Bryant definitely had an impact on all these players in the court right here, and a lot of these people in the crowd for sure.
Yeah, it's been really interesting to see in these past few days just how many facets of life Kobe Bryant touched in his life. Obviously the basketball world, the sports world, the media world had an Oscar to his name. A guy a lot of us looked up to, I think we could speak on behalf of both of us as well, just as sports fans. So a nice tribute by either side to get this one going. But back to game action. Jordan Francis kicking it out to Daquan Kaskar for three.
Yeah, nice little shot there from the corner. Good luck.
A rapid start to this one. Here's Johnny Richardson. Guarded by Kaskar. He'll pull up mid-range jumper. That one's good. Both sides trading buckets here early.
Yeah, nice shot there. Very tough to defend that.
The big man, Cy Samuels. Inside, he goes to Francis. What an addition he's been during this second half. Fousey for three, that won't go. Offensive rebound, Jalen Morgan. Talked pregame just how valuable he's been to the Hawks this year.
And he continues to make his case for All-Canadian.
Last time on home floor, he dropped an even 40. What a game that was. Johnny Richardson high off glass and good. Niagara brings this one to 5-4.
Quick 4 points here for Johnny Richardson. I wonder if he's going to continue to heat up here as this game continues along.
Francis going to go for a drive off the glass and in.
Nice move. Heard a few oohs from the Humber bench. They like that one.
Hard to blame him. There's Hilton fouled at midcourt.
A little too much contact there.
That one's going to go against Cy Samuels, his first. And we mentioned earlier they're going to have to be pretty physical with Laquan Hilton in the game he plays. Nice look off the glass from Richardson there.
Yeah, not necessarily an easy shot, but he made it work.
Richardson with the rock now. He has all 4 points for the Knights. He'll go down low, trying to work his way into the paint. That one's swatted away. And there's going to be another foul this time, once again, against Cy Samuel.
Yeah, he's understandably frustrated there, already picking up his second of the game. Looks like he's going to take a break here.
Inside they go. Staying under Jordan Francis there, making the bucket. That's Stephon Augusta. So Samuels has two fouls to his name. He'll go baseline to Daquan Kaskar. Looking for assistance. He'll go all the way across the floor to Fousey. That one rims out, but gets his own rebound. No look kick out to Kaskar. Driving the paint off the glass and a big block. And we're going to see a foul. Kaskar going to go to the line for two.
And Niagara Knights can't believe that one. And I want to go back to that Fousey Muhammad play. Good shot by him there. He doesn't usually miss those. Ends up getting his own rebound, making it work.
Look here at some of that hard contact Daquan took. Nice work by the Knights to get up there and contest that shot.
I think Augustine's still in a little bit of disbelief over that foul call.
No good on attempt number one for Daquan. Second one will drop. It's 8-6 Hawks here early. Just under 3 minutes into the action here. Hilton guarded by Francis. In the corner they go. That's Larmont. Inside, that's pulled away by Daquan Kaskar. Here's Jordan Francis with friends. Keith Laria with the finish.
Great defense leading a great offense there. Great all-around team play.
Johnny Richardson, he's been big for Niagara thus far. Barty back to Richardson. He has his head up. He needs some help. guarded tightly by Francis. Inside he goes, shot clock down to 7. On the baseline, mid-range jumper, and a travel is called. No bucket. So good ball movement on that possession for Niagara. Don't get rewarded with any points, though. Fousey back away for the Hawks. Finding Jalen Morgan. What a run he's been on. In the corner, moving around the horn to Francis. That one will brick out as well.
Some great unselfish play there by the Hawks. Unfortunately, didn't convert into a couple points, though.
Both teams get their look, yet to capitalize. That one lifts out. Kaskar gets that one pulled away from him, and an easy bucket for Raheem Barty.
Yeah, a little bit of a tough break from Kaskar, and another tough break for Kaskar there.
Augustin
losing the ball
picks,
two times.
Picks the pocket there. Inside it goes. Big man going up for the layup, and Barty once again makes a pay.
And just like that, this is a tie ball game.
See the Niagara women keep the game tight in the first quarter. The men doing the same. Jalen for 3. Jalen's got it.
Big bucket there. They needed that one.
And with the run he's been on, it's just like you don't ever expect him to miss a shot. Good defense there by Kaskar, breaking up the play.
Lucky break there for Jalen. He left his feet there.
Let's take a look at that last three made. The nice behind-the-back feed from Fousey and Morgan.
All kinds of time and space for Jalen Morgan. He's not going to miss on those too often.
Kevin O'Doo into this game for Daquan Kaskar. Keith Laria. Also some of the fresh legs on the floor. Jalen inbounds to Laria. Francis. Trying to work his way around Hilton. Here's Petronas. Going to go off the glass and in. Alex Petronas making his presence felt.
Great way to get himself into this ball game.
Had his Humber career high, 12 points last time out against the Falcons. Hilton pulls up for 3, won't go. Defensive rebound for the Hawks. Here's Jordan Francis.
That shot there by Hilton caught everyone off guard.
Number 4 with a quick 4 points for the Hawks. Petronas getting busy on the offensive side of the floor.
Yeah, looks like Niagara may not have had the best scouting report on him. We'll see if they adjust.
Open look here for the Knights. And that one is good. A smooth stroke from Kenan Lamont. Jalen going cross court into the corner. Kevin O'Toole going to be charged with the foul.
Yeah, Kevin O'Toole in a little bit of the happy feet going there.
Niagara responding with a 3-point of their own. That's Lermond making no mistake. He's the man with the rock now, being chased by Petronas and O'Toole. He'll kick it to Johnny Richardson. He'll have a go from beyond the arc. And now it's going to go off Petronas. Under the rim, it'll be Niagara Knights basketball.
Yeah, bad break from there. Just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Went off his back. Right, just as he was underneath that basket.
Hilton on the inbound, off the shin of his own man. That's Daniel locally.
And Alex Petronas will take a big sigh of relief there.
No harm, no foul for the Hawks as they come back away on the offensive side of the floor. Justice Salmon going hard to the rim. Can't get that one to drop. Richardson once more for the Knights. Guarded by Salmon. Go cross court. That one poked away by O'Toole.
Almost came away with that one.
Richardson going to pull up from the foul line. Won't drop. Offensive rebound. And that won't go either. Nice work by Augustin, but can't get the shot to drop. Justice Salmon. Head of steam taking some contact. He'll find his way to the line.
A good start here for the Humber Hawks. 5-point lead just in the closing, or the midpoint of the first quarter, rather. Definitely what you'd like to see, getting some good points, getting some good defense. Got to work at that consistency maybe a little bit more.
Yeah, certainly not the highest scoring first quarter that we've seen, but the ball movement's been there, the creativity's been there. It's just a lot of these shots just haven't got the lucky bounce, haven't dropped yet for Humber. But so far, a pretty fluid, pretty fast start for either side.
Yeah, you got like, and with the regards to the shots that they have made, stuff like that tends to even itself out throughout the course of the ball game. So, should even out later on.
Salmon makes good on the second attempt. 18-12, the Hawks lead here. Just over 3.5 minutes to play here in quarter number 1. Hilton, average leading scorer for the Knights, trying to dish off. A lot of traffic under the rim there. Hilton trying to dribble out on that baseline. We're going to have a foul called as Khalid Adam begins to prep to come into tonight's action.
Big man from Qatar coming into this one. We've seen him be a difficult matchup problem for a lot of teams. Let's see how Niagara responds.
With the big man on the floor, we'll see how that changes things for Niagara defensively. Laquan Hilton will just watch the time for the shot clock expire, and Andrew didn't appear as though he had any idea how much time was left on the clock.
Yeah,
that's
where my mind was at as well. I don't think he knew how much time was left on the shot clock.
Wheel Martin here trying to find Patronus. Instead, it's 0-2 in the corner. Can't get that to go. Offensive rebound being battled for by Adam. It will remain Humber basketballs. That's off the fingertips of Daniel Locally.
Yeah, even though that shot wasn't intended for 0-2, still a good shot there from the corner. He's liking what Humber's doing a lot of the right things.
Wheel Martin inbounds to Adam. He'll get the rock right back, going behind the back. Nice looking move. Mid-range jumper. Won't get the hop. Justice Salmon, offensive rebound, won't go. Whole lot of bodies under there, and it's the team in blue that comes away. Johnny Richardson with help, reverse layup. Good, that's a mighty fine looking play there.
Yeah, really Richardson. Tough play there. He took a lot of contact on the way to the rim. The chance here for the three-point play for number three.
Let's see what Richardson has in store. Shooting 67% from the line.
Close ball game, those aren't the opportunities you like to give up.
Just a one possession game here, 18 to 15. Martin with the rock, he'll find Adam. Patronus trying to cut in towards the rim, but good defense. Salmon driving baseline, whole lot of contact. It'll be an offensive foul. Here's a look at that last play. And a good one at that by Richardson.
Looks like the Humber player just stepped out of bounds there. No foul being called.
Good eye, Andrew. So touching that baseline did the Hawks on that play. Patronus with the steal. He has Salmon with him. Bounce pass. And that one lips out. A free opportunity for Justice. Can't get it to go.
We talked about shots not falling. That's kind of the epitome of things right there.
And a shot falls for the Knights there. Laquan Hilton for three. We have a tie ball game once more.
Humber had that lead up to a nice margin before, but Niagara keeps climbing back.
Patronus protects the rock there, goes hard to the hoop, regains the lead for the Hawks.
We talked about Niagara being 4-9, but there's definitely no pushover.
They came to play tonight, hostile territory inside the Hawks' nest as Richardson gets another mid-range jumper to go.
Once again, it's high ball game.
9 points on the board for Johnny Richardson. Adam tries to back his man up, and he'll get the two to drop as he hustles back on defense.
I think he's looking for the foul there, didn't get it.
Hilton guarded tightly by Kevin 0-2. He'll kick it out here to Locally. Can't get that layup to drop. Gonna have another foul. One once again going against the Hawks.
Another look at that complete Adam shot.
Mentioned he could be a little bit of a mismatch for a lot of these teams, Andrew. Standing at 6'8", he's a big body to guard.
Yeah, and look at the Niagara roster, the tallest player, Jonathan Raven, only 6'5", only 6'5", I say.
Hilton with another three for the Knights.
Only in basketball would you say 6'5", if you have the word only before it. Volleyball too, maybe, but not too many other places.
Good defensive play by Hilton. He's getting busy all over the floor here for the Knights. He'll pull up for another J. That one just lips out. Offensive rebound put away by the big man, John Raven, the man you just mentioned.
Gotta get that box out going. He's a big man, but you got a bigger man.
Trying to shore up this defense are the Hawks here. 30 seconds remain as McKeel Martin gets that jumper to drop. 1 point margin here for the Knights. That bounce pass won't get through Martin and Adam.
Kick ball.
Here's that last basket. So good look at Hilton and what he could do with the rock. You can start to see why he's averaging about 20 points per game. Really offensive-minded player.
He's a dangerous player.
Speaking of dangerous, here's Richardson going high off the glass. That'll rim out. Cascar directing traffic. That one tipped. Fauzi corrals it. Jalen in the corner. Shot clock expiring. Jalen gets it off, and Jalen gets it to go. Nice in the face. Wow.
How do you not love that? Can we just call him an Canadian already?
What in the world is the OCAA gonna do about Jalen Morgan? How do you stop this man?
I got your answer. You can't.
Jeez, that's only for two, but that's about the prettiest two you'll see. Step back, shot clock expiring, that rainbow goes.
Yeah, from our angle, it's hard to see the three-point line, but Laquan Hilton was playing at the ref about that three-point call, and it's easy to understand why now after getting that replay, but still, just a magnificent shot. Ice in the veins, like you said.
26-25, what an exclamation point to wrap up that first quarter. We touched on Jalen Morgan pregame about how he's on a pace unlike something we've ever seen, not just in the Humber Hawks, but maybe the whole OCAA. He's off to a quick start with 7 points already.
Yeah, we'll see how this game continues. You know, he's definitely going to look to have another great game here tonight. Of course, we mentioned the last time he was here in the Hawks, that he put up 40. I don't know if he's going to put up that again, but definitely look for Jalen to have another big night.
I'm certainly not going to be the man to doubt him as we take a look at some of the replays over the first quarter. Just about set for second quarter action here. The official word, that last shot by Jalen Morgan, his time expired. Was for two, not three, as that toe just touched the line. Doesn't take away the degree of difficulty for that shot by any means.
100% agree. Great shot.
So Cascar gonna get this thing started here in quarter number two. Down low, it's Jalen Morgan. You got to imagine they'll be guarding him tight. He'll turn around with a jump shot. Doesn't miss by much. Hilton dribbles that off his own foot. Cascar from his backside finds Fauzi. He'll find the glass and find 2 points.
Great job there to create that one.
Humber Hawks manufacturing offense here. Richardson guarded by Fauzi to locally. He'll have a go, and that'll touch nothing but air. So a couple bodies coming into this game for the Knights. Raheem Barty and Kenan Lamont, two starters, back into action. Taking a seat is Wint and Raven. Fresh legs on the floor for Niagara. We'll see if they can stop this Humber attack. Jalen once again down low on the baseline, finding Jordan Francis. Francis gonna head towards the paint, and he'll get the tough layup to drop.
Francis found that lane, and nothing was going to stop him there on the way of the hoop.
Francis rejoining this team in the second half of the season. What an addition he's been. So valuable to this club. Holds it guarded tightly. Here's Richardson, guarded by Noel Bailey. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Richardson can't get the roll. Back away comes Bailey.
Great defense there by Humber, playing him real tough.
Fauzi off the rim. Rebound for Richardson. Here's Lamond, a little bit of slip there.
Almost lost the ball. And on that play, Noel Bailey, just a little too physical there on that loose ball.
A look at what Jordan French just accomplished on the offensive side of the floor. He had 14 points last time out against Fanshawe. Hilton with the jump pass to Larmond. And that one's good, the sharpshooter, with another one on the board for the Knights.
Still a tight ball game. Niagara only down by two.
Whole lot of contact under that rim. Kaskar shaking his head. Going to take a whole lot more to stop me. See Larmond. A smooth stroke there. That rainbow goes. It's a one possession game, Andrew. The Knights have really kept it tight all throughout the match.
Yeah, I got to give them a lot of credit. Their players really came out here with a lot of heart and a lot of hustle. They want to come into here in the Hawks Nest, want to get that W. Easier said than done, of course, but you got to like how they've played so far.
Last time these two teams played, the Hawks did take the victory, their second of the season, but it took an OT period. These two teams, no stranger to tight contests. Locally misses a three in the corner. Kaskar with a whole lot of speed. He has Jalen with him. He'll go to the hoop and get the bucket.
Soft hands on the way of the hoop by Jalen Morgan. He's a big man, but he can do it all.
Jalen's got nine so far tonight. And that errant pass heads out of bounds. It'll be Hawks basketball, and he's starting to feel the momentum slowly starting to shift Humber's way.
Yeah, 6-point lead now for the Hawks. They're starting to feel pretty good about their game, you gotta imagine. And they really haven't done anything too much to change up the way they play, just their shots just start to fall.
The offense beginning to click on all cylinders here. Francis taking his time, he'll find Jalen. Inside it goes to Laria. Around the horn they go, Jalen for three, and that's money.
He's already up to 12 points here early in the second quarter.
We mentioned he's averaging 28 over his last three games. Seems well on his way thus far. Richardson tightly guarded here by Francis. He'll find the floor. And a foul will go against the Hawks.
And Francis couldn't believe that call. He's down on the ground, his eyes were wide open. I think he thought for sure that call was going the other way.
Here's Hilton with the rock on the perimeter, and another foul is going to be called, this time against Keith Laria.
Got to watch the fouls, already up to three in this quarter. It was a problem early on for the Hawks in that four-game losing streak, and it's got them in a little bit of difficulty since then, but they managed to play their way out of it.
An easy layup there for Raheem Barty. Quick outlet here to Jordan Francis. Laria's under the rim. He'll take a couple swats, and he'll head to the line. Foul charged there to the Knights.
Yeah, he took a lot of contact on that one. Really no surprise of the foul call there.
Seen this play here, that's a pretty open look for Barty. Jalen Morgan maybe getting a little mixed up on his assignment there.
Yeah, looks like it.
So Keith Laria, another one of these second half assists for this team. A few players joined the lineup. Mentioned Alex Petronas, Keith Laria, Dwayne Lambert, Kador, obviously Jordan Francis getting back at the pitcher, that's huge. This team had a whole lot of reinforcements as they start to push through towards OCAA Provincials, CCAA Nationals, which, oh, by the way, is going to be right inside the Hawks Nest.
Is it going to be March 18th to the 21st right here in the Hawks Nest?
I believe so. I know we'll be here.
It's going to be a good one. I can guarantee that.
These Hawks really think they have a special second half ahead of them. And why wouldn't you think that with some of the performances they've put up as of late?
Of course, having home court advantage doesn't hurt at all. Last time Humber hosted the tournament in 2001, they won it.
Yeah, check the documentary. We got it on record. CBC did a nice doc of that team. Keith Laria with a nice little floater, getting that layup to go.
Leads up to 10 now.
40-30, your Hawks lead. Inside they go to Barty. That pass intercepted by Jalen. Back away come the Hawks. Jordan Francis with a head of steam, and he'll get two. And a timeout upcoming for the Niagara Knights. Phil Mosley has seen enough.
Yeah, really no surprise there. Humbert got a pretty serious run there. And all that took was really one more offensive chance that didn't go your way and one more defensive chance that didn't go your way. A quick timeout.
It really appears these transitions have been working to perfection with Humber. Obviously, they have a pretty big roster, but there's plenty of speed as well. And they've really been utilizing that to their strength so far in this first half.
Yeah, when you got speed and you're passing the ball as well as Humber has been, that's a dangerous combination. Oh, yeah, and they're a good defensive team, too. So it's a tough assignment for any team to really come in here, especially to beat them in their own barn.
Absolutely. And with their speed and their ball movement, that rock's moving around so much defensively, it's kind of tough to stay tight on your defensive assignments. And when you have sharpshooters like Jalen Morgan, you have Fauzi Muhammad, guys that can shoot up and spot up from any spot on the floor. It's going to be tough for any defense, and I think Niagara is starting to realize that here early.
Yeah, you see that in a lot of plays where they're just able to cross the team up, and you get that man wide open in the corner or wherever for three, and even if they don't make it, just getting that chance, that's a big deal.
So the Hawks have opened up a pretty healthy 12-point lead here. Niagara Knights fighting hard. Inbound to Johnny Richardson. Jordan Francis is going to be with him the whole way. Niagara looking for an open look. They haven't had too many. Locally gets that pass intercepted. Jalen back away. Got Jordan Francis with him. The lob pass is there. Francis turns around, but that's partially deflected.
Yeah, a bit of a bad break there. I think Jalen Morgan was trying to get that alley-oop there to Jordan Francis. Not quite in position. Unable to convert there.
A whistle here. It's going to be Humber Hawks basketball. Fauzi's going to be on the inbound. Alex Petronis rising to his feet. He'll take out Dwayne Lambert-Cador.
Petronis got hot the last time he was in this ballgame. Let's see if he can rekindle some of that magic.
Petronis put up his Humber career high 12 points last time out against Fanshawe. A hard work bucket there for Keith Laria. Hands all over him, still puts it up and in.
Yeah, Phil Mosley, coach of the Niagara Knights, not happy with that one. A few words for his team there.
It's one of those plays where, hey, give him the bucket, give him the foul. Don't give him both. I'm sure that's what's on the mind of Phil Mosley. Here's Kenan Lermond. He's been a sharp shooter for the Knights, but that pass deflected out of bounds as we see Cy Samuels check back into this game. Here come in for Jalen. Cy Samuels with two fouls to his name, something to keep an eye on as this game wears on. Petronis is going to guard the inbound. It's to Hilton. Push foul against Jordan Francis. Harris Hilton tried to avoid him. Mentioned earlier, Hilton averages over 20 points a game. He has just six thus far. NASCAR coming back into the game.
Yeah, seems to be a little bit of a jersey issue with Kevin O'Too. Something about the collar. I wasn't quite able to get the full thing.
We'll try to read the lips and keep you updated here about the equipment malfunction. Laquan Hilton gonna pull up from range and gets that tough shot to drop. So the Knights staying alive here, 45-32 they trail. Petronis in the paint. Just doesn't get the roll there. Keith Laria.
That was a great no-look pass there by Cy Samuels, though.
Laria with the old Euro step, trying to work around his man. Will draw contact and the foul.
Yeah, foul's going to be on Raven here.
See that tough shot drop for Hilton on that last possession. He's starting to heat up just a little bit here for the Knights. See a word there between Kaskar and O'Too. Laria makes good on attempt number one. We've seen a lot of Keith since he's entered this roster for Samson Downey. They like what he brings to the table for this team. Just another scoring threat to go along with the countless others.
This is a deep Hawk squad, make no bones about it. And any of these guys can really play a big role come playoff time, so it's going to be interesting to see how the rotations shake out.
Any guy could step up on any night. Here's locally wide open. That one a little long. Side Samuel, the rebound master for the Hawks, back away. Kevin O2 on the perimeter, going cross court to Cascar. He'll drive baseline. That pass deflected, corralled by O2. Nice move to get inside, taking the layup to drop. Samuel once more on the rebound, trying to tip this one in, but it's the Knights who come away. 4 minutes to go in half number one as Laquan Hilton tries to work around O2. Getting double teamed there, pulled away by Cascar. 0-2 going up.
Oh, come on.
Oh, and he misses the two-handed slam. Can't get the putbacks to go either. A missed opportunity there for the Hawks. Hilton almost makes him pay there, 4-3. Hawks need to be a little bit more efficient here with their shooting.
Yeah, they do a couple sloppy plays here in those last couple offensive possessions.
Petronas gives up the look to Laria, and that goes everywhere but through the hoop.
That's just bad luck.
Johnny Richardson gonna spot up. That won't drop. Missed opportunities on either side of the floor. Here's Petronas against Richardson using his size advantage to get the layup to go off the noggin. 49-32, Humber leads. As the Niagara Knights call a timeout. Pretty healthy 17-point lead. And for the Hawks, they're playing great, but some of these shots just aren't dropping for them today.
No, like there's a little bit of a sloppy series back there. And Niagara calls the timeout there, but Humber might be a little thrilled that they got that timeout so they can do a little housekeeping here during that timeout.
Nice work by Petronas on that last possession. He saw he was one-on-one with Johnny Richardson there. Certainly had the height advantage, hit up with the little Euro step, go over the top of him and get the easy bucket.
Well, I'll talk a little bit about that double team before. We had double team there in Kevin O2. Ty Samuels both going for it. Cascar gets the pickoff. That play to O2. Went for the dunk. Unfortunately, it just didn't work.
Yeah, it's one of those times where whenever there's a breakaway play like that, the guy is all out on his own. All of a sudden, the crowd goes quiet. The alumni goes quiet. Everybody's waiting for that man to get up. And give him credit. He certainly went up with both hands, but just coming up inches short. The dunk there.
I mean, I've never come close to dunking whatsoever, but I can imagine that's pretty frustrating.
Yeah, a couple of dunk experts over here at courtside at the broadcast table. We'll leave it to the professionals. Daniel locally going to inbound it here for the Knights. Raheem Barty. He's been a factor offensively for Niagara, guarded by Petronas. He'll work around his man, kick it out wide. Johnny Richardson on the perimeter. Now locally, won't go. Cy Samuel on the rebound. Kevin O2 with it now, guarded tightly. Cascar in the corner, back to O2. Inside Delaria. And that errant pass will give the possession back to Niagara.
In the final 3 minutes of the first half, Hawks leading by 17. Let's see what they can do here to close out the half.
The fans clapping it up for Kevin O2 as he heads off the floor. Hawks with a full court press here late. And Petronas going to take the foul there. Not the spot on the floor you want to be taking fouls deep in defensive territory.
Yeah, definitely not.
That'll be just the first foul. Charge to Alex Petronas.
Niagara in the bonus now, though.
Something to keep an eye out for. Petronas, an interesting story. He's a third-year eligible player. Has played a season with the Dalhousie Tigers out east and the George Brown Huskies right here in Toronto. He is a Toronto native. Happy to have him in the navy and yellow. Cascar in the inbound, a little sloppy, but the Hawks do manage to handle it. Bowsy into the corner. Here's Petronas. Did everything he could to get to the hoop, but couldn't get over Barty. Here's Laquan Hilton. That pass gets away from him, and Cy Samuel, Daquan Kaskar, he'll go up for two, and that's the finish the Hawks were looking for.
And they got that dunk on that breakaway. The crowd here loves it.
Kaskar sticking like glue to Laquan Hilton there. Seeing the fire he brings to the floor. Johnny Richardson finds himself a lane. Good rebound there by Keith Laria. Here's Fauzi. He'll go inside the Patronus, taking plenty of contact. He'll head to the line. But the Hawks going a little bit harder than the Globetrotters with all these passes as we take a look at the two-hander from Kaskar.
Yeah, we've seen this from Kaskar a few times. Get that big slam dunk. And right away going to his defensive assignment. Gotta love that hustle.
That's what I love. Kaskar so often is gonna be guarding the number one offensive threat on the other team. And he's not guarding you physically, he's guarding you emotionally. He's gonna get in your head, he's gonna get right in your face. So much fun to watch, the energy he brings to the floor.
Pretty demoralizing for his opponent, I gotta imagine.
He's got me imitated, I'm on his side. So back away, Raheem Barty for the Knights. They trail in a big way with 2 minutes to go in the half. White seven blocking foul. That's Daquan Kaskar. Kaskar pleading his case to the official here. And with a shake of the head, I don't think the official's having any of it. So Laquan Hilton. Gonna get two from the line.
Yeah, not the guy you want to send there. Almost an 89% free throw shooter. No mistake on both of those.
Sharp shooter, Hilton makes good on that opportunity. 51-36 Hawks lead here. Jalen at the top, finds Samuel. Kaskar's gonna give it a go. That one will rim out. Chasing down his own rebound. Daquan Kaskar and one.
Pretty good right now. Up to 10 points this ball game, a chance for 11.
And that may be a straight face, but Daquan Kaskar fired up.
Oh, you better believe it.
Got an and one, don't expect him to miss. Right back to that assignment as you see him in the hip pockets of Laquan Hilton. Here's one last work. Look at the handiwork of Kaskar. Barty gets around his man, Hilton from the parking lot. Won't go, rebound Justice Salmon, knocked away by Barty. And it'll be Humber basketball. A lot of contact under the hoop for either side in this game. The big fellas doing battle. Inside to McKeel Martin, nice pass to Justice Salmon. Turnaround shot, won't drop. Hilton with his friend Kaskar there. Kenan Lamond, he's been money from range, but that won't go. Rebound Jalen Morgan. Fauzi with a rocket to Justice Salmon. How about the court vision there by Fauzi Muhammad?
Yeah, great pass. Finding his man right under the hoop for an easy bucket.
1 minute remains in half number one. Hilton's out wide. Kaskar had to work through that screen. In the corner, it's Barty, and that is good. Finally, the Knights respond here. 56-39 is the score. Fauzi guarded tightly into the corner. Jalen Morgan all day. He makes them pay. Jalen Morgan for three. Johnny Richardson spins around. Raheem Barty down low. He goes back inside to Barty off the glass and in. Both sides straight at buckets here late.
Hawks still have a big lead here, though. Chance here to finish off the half.
18 points the spread here as Fauzi gonna take his sweet time. Eight on the shot clock. Who else but Jalen gonna take the shot? Won't drop, a second left. They'll toss up a prayer. Off the rim and out, not a bad effort at all. Our first half is in the book. Your score, Humber Hawks 59, Niagara Knights 41. And who else but Jalen Morgan with 15 leading the way for the Hawks.
Yeah, no surprise there. We talked about how much of an impact he's had these last few games, averaging 28 his last three matches. And Well on his way to the same totals once again.
Yeah, it's the two really emotional leaders for the squad, Jalen Morgan and Daquan Kaskar, making a difference in a big way for their side. And for the Hawks, anything to improve on as we go to half number two, or just keep things as usual, keep the train rolling?
Yeah, I like the way they've been playing all game. Maybe just like fix up a few of those sloppy mistakes, but not too worried overall.
See Hilton there having a talk with his head coach, Phil Mosley. It's been a little bit of a frustrating night for their leading scorer. He does have 10 points. So we'll step away. That's all for the first half live from the Hawks Nest. Adam Lucher and Andrew Milani will be back with second half action on the Hawks Sports Network. We'll see you soon. action here from the Humber North Campus gym. Out of blue shirt, Andrew Mullaney on the call. Thanks for tuning in to the Hawk Sports Network. Should have a good finish here. Hawks lead the Niagara Knights by a score of 59-41. Raheem Barty leading the way for the Knights with 13 points. And who else but Jalen Morgan, 15, a Humber high in the first half. Barty continues his work. He puts up another two, make that 15. Tied for the game high with Jalen Morgan. In the corner, here's Jalen, passes up the look to give it over to Fousey. Daquan Cascard inside to Samuel, bounce pass to Daquan Cascard, and he'll draw the foul.
Hoop and the harm for Daquan Cascard, picking up right where he left off there at the end of the first half.
And how about that give and go there between Samuels and Cascard? Getting the bucket and a shot from the charity stripe. Make that a three-point play for Daquan Cascar. A nice start here early in the third quarter for the Hawks. Johnny Richardson directing his team. He'll dish it off to Hilton, guarded tightly by Jordan Francis. On the perimeter now are the Knights. In the corner, it's Barty. He's going to put it up and drain it. Raheem Barty. 17 points for him on the night. He's had a quick start to this second half. Fousey down low to Cascard, backing up Hilton. The floater drops. Daquan Cascard.
A difficult shot there by Daquan Cascard. Made it look easy.
Kendall Lamar trying to bring this one over midcourt. Fousey not going to let him do it easily. Foul's going to be card there. White six. That's Jordan Francis. Jordan Francis did not want to be taken out of this game, but will in a little bit of foul trouble as we take a look at that three from Raheem Barty. And we talked about Hilton coming into this game for the Knights. Maybe he's the guy offensively the Hawks need to look out for, but instead it's been Raheem Barty getting busy.
Yeah, he's had a big game here so far, 17 points.
A nice assist there to Augustin for Barty as he continues to get in on the offensive action. Jalen Morgan bobbles that pass, but able to maintain possession. He'll step back, jumper won't go. The deflection by Cy Samuels will. 66-47, the Humber Hawks lead.
Sorry, Adam.
Apologies there to seeing Barty go hard to the hoop there. He hits the floor. Cascar steals this one away. How about the work by Cascar?
Yeah, 6 points already in this half.
Fousey being an annoyance for Johnny Richardson. He's going to let that one go and bricks off the front part of the rim. Back and forth action here in quarter number three. Stolen away here, Laquan Hilton. He'll kick it over to Kenan Lamar, sharpshooter, going to have a go. And that one is good. The lead now 18 for the Hawks at 68-50.
Still a sizable lead for the Hawks, but Niagara's managed to find a way to kind of keep it around that 2018 mark.
Here's Jalen, thought about spotting up. Instead, back to Laria he goes, 10 on the shot clock. Did everything he could there. Does draw the foul, Keith will go to the line. So we have a look. That last possession there, Hilton stealing it away. The nice spinorama. Kenan Lamont. He's had a lot of open looks in this game, Andrew, and he's made good on most of them. Number eight for the Knights. Getting busy. He has 10 points on the evening.
Yeah, already in those double digits. He's been dangerous from deep. You know they're going to want to keep feeding him the rock.
Especially with this deficit, that three-point shot is going to be huge for Niagara as this game moves on. Big block for Jalen Morgan, jack of all trades. Cascar treads back to get that one. Let's see what Fousey can do. He'll spot up for three. Fousey from the parking lot.
The all-time three king for Humber does it again.
That's what he's known for, the three on the back for a reason as we take a look at the defensive prowess of Jalen Morgan. Your Humber Hawks student-athlete of the week, getting it done defensively. Larmond gonna have another go. That one rattles all the way around and out. Cascar in transition. shot there. The foul on Kenan Lamond for the push. Mousy, how many times we've seen that shot? Not a guy that always needs to get his toes right up to the line. He's just fine taking a few steps back from that arc and letting it fly.
Yeah, dangerous long-range shooter fit by every definition of those words. Yeah, he's just so dangerous for anywhere behind that arc. And he's a good playmaker, too, which makes him super dangerous. You never be too careful when defending him.
Patronis in the corner misses that three-point attempt. Raheem Barty for the Knights. A lot of T-shirts in white around him. Johnny Richardson somehow gets away. Tries to find Hilton, but that'll roll harmlessly out of bounds. And Phil Mosley with a shake of the head and a swat of the hand. Not too happy with that possession.
No, it can't be right there. They fell right into the Humber's trap right there.
6.5 to go. Quarter number three, 71-50. The Hawks lead. Fousey.
Oh.
How does that not drop? Half the ball past the rim, but instead it rolls right out. Too much English.
Half. I give you give up all three quarters was in there.
Barty kicks it out wide. That's Richardson. Good for three. Richardson has 12 for himself on the night. How about that move, Jalen Morgan?
Took a lot of contact there, but no call.
Richardson right back the other way, drawing the foul. These last couple minutes have been like a game of tennis, Andrew.
Back and forth.
Getting us ready for a weekend of badminton action here on HSN.
That's absolutely right. Regionals tomorrow and Saturday.
Bringing you sports across the entire athletic spectrum here on HSN. Richardson.
Yep. I was going to ask, do you have much badminton experience?
Not a lick. Did play a little bit on the beach as a child.
Oh, there's a little bit. High school gym class too, you know?
In the goggles.
Yeah, there you go. Got to look fashionable while on the court.
Hawks looking fashionable out here tonight. Their lead nearly 20. It's 19 at the moment as we see Lambert Cador dish off to Patronis. He's working hard baseline, trying to back off his man. And we'll have ourselves a foul. It's going to go the Knights' way. That foul's going to be charged to Patronis.
Yeah, he can't believe it. Had his hands on his head.
So that'll be the second foul on the day for Alex. Connor Jolliffe out wide on the perimeter. Goes inside to Hilton. Bounce pass. And the travel's going to be called. You see the shocked face of Dwayne Lambert-Cador. He thought that foul was on him. As soon as he saw that travel call, a little sigh of relief. That baseball toss in to Keith Laria gets the Humber Hawks started. Jalen Morgan with patience. Nice spinning move there off the glass and out. Khalid Adam trying to rebound that one. Patronis can't keep it in bounds.
Yeah, that foot just on the line there. After a tough shot made by Jalen Morgan.
So we'll see Kevin O'Too check back into this game. He'll take out Jalen Morgan. Another great day for Jalen. Knights certainly have some work to do here as they let that one get away from them. Foul against Keith Laria. He's having words with the Humber bench. Not too pleased with that call.
Yeah, already his third personal. He's in foul trouble.
A new piece for Samson Downey and the Hawks, but certainly an important one. You see him check out with a little bit of foul trouble.
Yeah, giving him some real big minutes here in the rotation. Obviously, he trusts him.
Noel Bailey going to get back in. And that's big to not only have new players come in for the second half of the semester, or maybe the new semester, the winter term. But these are guys that Samson Downey really trusts. Jordan Francis is a veteran of this program. Keith Laria, you can tell by playing time, the coaching staff really likes what he contributes. These aren't just new depth options. These are some high-flying scorers. Certainly going to be valuable for the postseason push. another one of those additions. Alex Petronas draws some contact there.
Yeah, a lot of good veteran players coming in here. All those guys you mentioned, all third-year players by OCAA rules, and all putting in some good work here.
And this rim has been not too favorable for the Humber Hawks here in the third quarter. That one lips out for Petronas. Second one will go. 74-56 now your score. The Hawks leading by a healthy margin here at the Hawks Nest. Lambert Cador sticking with his man the whole way. Now Kevin O'Toole draws the assignment. And how about that layup? Johnny Richardson didn't look like he had an angle there, Andrew.
Yeah, nice fancy finish there to complete that play. Didn't think he had a chance.
Here's Noel Bailey. Driving hard to the rim, won't drop. Khalid Adam cleans that one up.
6'8" big man, so hard to guard.
Quan Hilton, nice bounce pass to find his man. That's Raven. The big men go up against each other. Raven comes away with it. Bounce pass down low. This rock is bouncing everywhere. And it's Noel Bailey that comes away. Petronas to the corner. Lambert Couture inside to Khalid Adam. That won't drop as the big man misses that opportunity. Hilton over half court now, trying to cross up Bailey. And that'll be a foul charge to 21 in white. Noel Bailey with the push.
It's first of the game. Second of the game, rather.
As we take a look at the handiwork by Bailey there, nice. Finish attempt with the left hand. Good thing Khalid Adam, the big man, was right under the hoop. Mentioned earlier, Andrew, Hilton's not the man you want to send to the line, but misses his second opportunity. Petronas with a nice little move to evade his man. High off the glass, won't go. Khalid Adam can't get the tip in.
Almost got that put back in the head.
That's his type of game. You got to imagine if there's a miss on the offensive glass, Khalid Adam is not going to be too far away. A lot of communication between Samson Downey and the men on the floor. Petronas on the inbound. Bounce pass right into Bailey, and that's a quick bucket for the Hawks.
Yeah, nice what you want to see there. A nice quick bucket. Real efficient.
Full court press here by Humber. Hilton at the logo. Fousey guarding the inside, now switches off with Petronas. They try to go inside to Lokale, but nice work by Lambert Couture. Head up, he finds Bailey. He's got some momentum behind him. Back to Lambert Couture. Petronas in the corner. He gets that one ripped away. Johnny Richardson with the handiwork. Hilton for three. That's a brick as it rims out. Petronas going to slow the pace in this one. Fousey behind the back trying to steer away from Hilton. He'll pick up a screen from Khalid Adam. Bailey in the paint now, fighting through contact, gets his own rebound, trying to go up and put it away. No, Bailey going to find his way to the line. That's a big play there for the Hawks.
And Coach Samson Downey loved that one, pumped his fist in the air right after that. How can you not love that?
See a little bit of a cast on the left hand of Samson Downey. That's not going to stop it. Stop him from clapping it up for his men on the floor. Certainly a lot to be happy about on that Humber bench tonight. You think this is a team just a few months ago that you needed OT to better. And all of a sudden here late in the third quarter, you're up by over 20 points.
Yeah, completely different look from this Hawks team earlier on the season. It looked like they were struggling to find that identity a little bit. Maybe a little bit too concerned with their own individual stats, but right now playing like a well-oiled machine.
Lokale misses that one in the corner, but it's put away by Raven. The big man picking up the offensive board and the bucket. Fousey with a spin move there. trying to find his man in the corner. Lambert Cador, Jalen Morgan, Bailey, Fauzi around the horn they go. Some sweet handles in a phone booth by Fauzi, but it's ripped away. And Fauzi will pick up the foul. So despite no points on that possession, Andrew, you sure got to like that ball movement.
Double dribble being called against Fauzi.
Here's Raheem Barty trying to get that bounce pass through off Kevin O'Toole. It goes. Possession will stay with the team in blue. Raheem Barty and his 17 points. Going to inbound it. He'll find John Raven. Back to Laquan Hilton. He's double teamed outside on the perimeter, needs help. There's Barty. He's gonna spot up for a mid-range J. That won't drop. Nice work by Kevin O'Toole to swat it away, but it finds its way to Barty. Locally, bricks out that three. The Hawks in transition now. Lambert Cador, Euro step, won't drop. Locally, defensive rebound. Hilton trying to get away from Lambert Cator and Jalen Morgan. Sticks out one arm and almost rips that one right off the top of his head.
And Hilton went right to the ground on that one.
And poor Jalen, what could you do? I know the man hit the floor, but when you have that much strength, that much size, you make contact with that ball, that man's not going to let it go. He's hit the floor.
Every time.
So Jalen picks up the foul.
Both teams in the bonus here, the final minute 30 of the third quarter.
Wilson makes no mistake. A near 90% shooter from the charity stripe. Offensive rebound by Raheem Barty, and you hear the disgust coming from Samson Dowdy on the sideline. Not liking giving up that offensive board.
Yeah, especially off a free throw, you really want to get that box out going. Really got to protect that that paint area.
Foul here to Laquan Hilton as he reached in there.
So his third of the game.
So that'll send the sharpshooter, Fauzi Muhammad. Mentioned earlier, Andrew, he is the three-point king in program history. Also, one of the newer members of the 500 point club for this Humber program. Him and Jalen Morgan both joined that club earlier this month.
Yeah, definitely one of the great all-time Hawks basketball players.
Fauzi, a local product from right here in Rexdale. Raheem Barty finds Johnny Richardson. Richardson drives, find Raven, big man gonna go for the mid-range jumper, and that'll sink. Not the spot. You expect Raven to spot up.
Jalen left him a little wide open there. He took that shot and he did well. Jalen gets the two right back.
He drops the two and has a look back at the man guarding him.
Ooh, lucky break there.
Nice pass there by Fauzi. Here's Jalen, gonna spot up. No good, John Raven on the rebound, but Cy Samuel steals it away. Off Raven he goes. And that's some heads-up basketball by the veteran, Cy Samuels.
Yeah, that's why you gotta love Cy Samuels. A big heads-up play there. Cy, you know, does a lot of the dirty work for the team, you know, gets those rebounds offensively, defensively. A great playmaker as well. Definitely really completes the starting lineup.
Let's see what Jordan Francis could do. Trying to work around his man. Turns around with the J. Downey wanted the foul. Not gonna get it. Richardson in transition. Find his way into the interior. Instead, it's Barty going to pull up. No good on that attempt. Shot clock is off. Is that Aaron pass? Heads out of bounds. 85-66. Hawks up big here. Final few seconds going to tick away here in this third quarter. 10 remain. If the Knights maintain possession, they'll have the last look. It's Raheem Barty. Trying to spin away. That one partially blocked. But the foul's going to go against Jalen Morgan.
Yeah, Jalen's not happy about that one, but he did get him on the arm on the way up.
So with 3.8 to go in the third quarter, an opportunity for Barty from the line. Is 19 points tied with Jalen for game high. Samson wants Kevin O'Toole to dart in after this rebound. We'll see if Kevin tries to dive in. Cy Samuel on the rebound. Here's Kevin on the run. Fouls, he's going to get the rock. He's going to pull up for three. And that one misses by a pretty big margin here. 0.3 seconds left. It's going to be after a quick catch and shoot. And that one is nowhere near its home. 85-67, the Humber Hawks lead. And since that second quarter, Andrew, the lead's just stayed pretty consistent. Humber has kind of put this thing into cruise control.
Yeah, like we said before, Niagara's done a pretty good job keeping this in the 18 to 20 range, but still a big margin. If they want to potentially get back into this ball game, you know, get that lead, try and win it, they're going to have to put something together pretty quickly here. They're going to need, I might say, they might need a miracle.
It's getting pretty close to that point. I mean, I'm sure if you're Niagara, you want to utilize that three ball a little bit more. Raheem Barty has had a pretty good work. Even John Raven has been pitching in offensively, kind of down low in the interior. But those two-point plays aren't really going to make up this margin too fast. You got to imagine they're going to start looking for looks beyond the arc.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You got to start looking for those deep shots. It's obviously riskier, but you really can't play favorites at this point.
As we take a look at some of the highlights from the last quarter of action. Speaking of threes, Fousey dropped a big one there. Johnny Richardson on the other side has been busy. Hawks trying to collect their 12th straight W. What a run they've been on. We don't try to dwell on it too much, Andrew, but not too long ago, this team was 0-4. Four straight losses. Things were kind of looking doom and gloom, especially heading into CCAA, but they've certainly righted the ship.
Yeah, only a few months ago was that four-game losing streak to start the season, but it really does feel like an eternity ago at this point, the way this team is playing. 11 wins in a row, going for 12 tonight. They're certainly looking good.
Absolutely. Remember last year, this team started their season 17-18-0, I believe, so certainly a far cry from what they accomplished last year with a little bit of a sluggish start out of the gates, but they brought a nice win streak into that winter break, added some key pieces to this lineup, and I believe you said it before, a well-oiled machine.
Yes.
I think that's exactly what we're seeing out of Humber over these last few months.
Yeah, it's going to be important for Humber to finish off strong, only four games remaining after this one, rather. So they're going to try and keep that ball rolling.
Big block for the Knights there. That's Nirvon Augustin. Hilton goes around the screen. Jalen Morgan's out there on the perimeter guarding him. Inside it goes. That pass picked off by Kevin O'Toole. Going to try to turn this steal into points. Nice work by Morgan to run in on it. And he goes up with two hands and finishes off glass.
That one almost swatted away, but Jalen Morgan in there right in time and gets the bucket.
Morgan with a game-high 21.
Who'd have thunk it?
Yeah, why not, right? He's averaged 28 in his last three games. You got to imagine he's going to get up around that mark here tonight as we take a look at that last bucket from number 13.
He's on pace for somewhere around that high 20s range. So, yeah, certainly not out of the question for him to even score 30 tonight.
Here's Augustin. He'll kick that out to Barty. Going to the hoop. Floater goes. 87-69. Just under 9 minutes to play. Hawks lead by a sizable margin as Jalen goes in once more. And he's just starting to flex the muscles here late.
Power and finesse. Just an unstoppable combo.
That pass deflected away. Once again, that's Jalen Morgan. It may sound like a broken record, but the man won't stop making plays.
Can't complain about that.
The lead is 20. As Richardson finds himself a lane, and that running floater drops down. Lead down to 18. Jordan Francis back to Cy Samuel. Jalen with a soft bounce to Daquan Kaskar. Nice dish inside to Jordan Francis. Won't go. Here's Kenan Lermond. Nice feed to Raheem Barty. Getting it done. Good heads up play by Lermond there. Samuel to Fauzi. Over to Morgan. Here comes that ball movement. Kaskar in a familiar position. Working against Hilton. He'll go up and get the bucket.
A lot of contact there. No call. Samson Downey really wanted it.
Just the way Kaskar likes it. Oh, outside Samuel. The big man showing off the fancy feet in the hands.
Cy Samuels, where'd you get those moves? Love it.
Ben sure loved that one. Lead back to 20, 93-73. Johnny Richardson against Morgan. Here's Augustin trying to work around Samuel. That's a tough task. Floater won't go. Samuel evading his man. Goes up to Jalen in the corner. It's Kaskar. And he goes off the side of the backboard.
Yeah, bad break there.
Jalen Morgan with the steal, a spin, a pass, a wide open look for Jordan Francis. Won't go. Fauzi tries to swat that one away, but it's taken by Barty.
Love that effort, but no one on this team in the way of that pass.
A brick coming there from Hilton as Kaskar runs under this one. Heading baseline, nice spin move, trying to pass it to Jalen, but a little too hot on the feet.
Yeah, that ain't it, Chief.
Just under 7 minutes remain. See Samson Downey there in his second year of action as the Humberhawks head coach. Francis guarding Hilton. Bounce pass inside, Augustin, outside, Richardson, three, no good. That one goes off the stanchion and will be called dead. So substitutions incoming for the Knights. Take it to the floor, Reese Radobanko. Number five on your screen. Hopefully he gets some touches so I can say Reese Radobanko a whole bunch of times.
It's a great name.
Great name. Fauzi on the outside. Down low, Cy Samuel has an eye for the hoop. Instead, a bounce to Lambert Couture, and that pass right to the hands of head coach Samson Downey. Surely not the intended target.
He could bring it, though.
Certainly bring it. A good player on the floor in his time with the Humberhawks as well, Samson Downey. Jack of all trades. How about the athleticism by Richardson there? We've seen that time and time again tonight. Shifty player.
Yeah, he's been a tough one to stop here for the Hawks. A little bit of a matchup problem.
He's got 19. Second on Niagara to Raheem Barty with his 24. Inbounded to Fauzi. Lambert Couture. Francis Fauzi. Pump fake. Down low, Cy Samuel turning inside. And that's good, Cy Samuel.
Six points on the night for him, and his teammate Fauzi Muhammad all smiles right now.
Shot from the corner won't drop, and we're going to have a foul on that rebound attempt. It's going to go against Patronis as Barty was trying to collect that offensive rebound. On the replay here, Jordan Francis kicking it over to Fauzi. How about Cy Samuel? He's been working in a phone booth these last few possessions, and he's done a nice job.
Yeah, certainly doing well down low. And he's one of those guys where that's really his office, down low on that glass, getting those rebounds. Looked real good here tonight.
Barty now with a team high 26. Make that a game high. Dwayne Lambert Couture, another one of these players coming in for the winter term. Patronis picking up a block by Samuels. Here's Noel Bailey. Behind the back he goes, trying to get away from Barty. Here's Patronis going hard to the rim. doesn't get the bounce, battling for that rebound. Little head out of play.
Yeah, Samson Downey having a little conversation with the referee about how no foul was called on that Petronas shot.
I can tell by the number of blinks, Samson Downey not too happy with that call. Johnny Richardson, he's been dynamite tonight. That pass deflected, but it's Niagara that comes away with it. Raven to Barty, blocked by Noel Bailey, and he's going to be charged with the foul. Hands on the head for Samson Downey. He's able to laugh it off.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. It looks like you got all ball there.
I was just about to say it, Andrew. I had all ball, but there's a reason we're not in the gray and black. Maybe a little bit of karma here as Barty misses the first attempt. What a night he's had. Make it good on number two. 95-79, 5 minutes remain. Humber Hawks have been cruising all night tonight. They look to collect their 12th straight victory. What a start to 2020 it's been for this program. All that traffic down low. It's going to be Barty coming away with it. Augustin turns away. Radobanko loses it. Here's Keith Laria. Has Petronas with him. He'll take it himself. Keith Laria. Bringing this crowd to his feet.
What an addition to the Humber Hawks he's been. Making his presence known here.
Whole lot of energy just filled this building. Let's take a look at this one. Lay it down the hammer, Keith Larry.
Just filthy. Just filthy. I love that slam dunk.
And the bench is absolutely loving this. They are bobbing Keith Larry right now. Big Khalid Adam will not let him out of his sights.
Let him have it.
High fives all around. A lot of times that dunk is coming uncontested, but Keith Larry had a man in front of him and says, sorry, bro. You're going on my bedroom wall as a poster. Wow. So if you need an exclamation point as this game starts to wear down, there it is, Keith Laria.
We got to go to athletics and see if we can get a poster made of that.
I'm sure it'll be on the wall in the office shortly. This crowd was looking for a reason to pop off, and they found it there.
Oh, for sure. That got them into it, no doubt about it.
It's been a tough night for Phil Mosley and his Niagara Knights. Certainly came in tough. This was a one-point game after that first quarter, but since then, Humber Hawks have just been a little too much for these Knights.
Yeah, Niagara's kind of just been running on that treadmill since the second quarter, really. Kind of staying behind by that 18 to 20 range, keeping up, you know, shot for shot to Humber, but not being able to cut into that lead, which has got to be pretty frustrating.
So after all that excitement, things slow down as the inbound goes to Jalen Morgan. He's got 23 on the night. He'll lob it up, and hey, how about that? That lob pass is good for three. And hey, they're getting the bounces. That's the kind of run Jalen Morgan's been on. Even your passes are a three-point play.
Jalen Morgan thanking the heavens on that one.
And on
little
that
help
shot,
there.
Yeah, the Hawks reached the century mark in one of the most unusual ways I think I've ever seen. And Jalen's usually a pretty calm guy. Doesn't celebrate too much, even on his biggest nights. But he couldn't help throwing up the two fists after that one dropped.
He's got a little smile on his face right now. I see it.
Why wouldn't you?
Even on that 40-point night, wasn't celebrating too much, but said thank you there.
So the two plays of the Knights are that big slam and a lob pass. But hey, we'll take it. That's the way she goes.
Lob shot, as it were.
Lob shot, indeed. 20 points. This is the spread, 100-80. Keith Laria could have another goal. Oh, it just pops out. Keith Laria wanted to take the roof off this place.
And he would have.
Oh,
Daquan Kaskar right in front of us on the scores table here just collapsed.
We hope he's all right. Where did Kaskar go?
Oh, they'll need him. later on the season.
Mid-range jumper for Richardson goes. Hey, and on this possession, if I have a vote, can we get the ball to Keith Laria? Jalen Morgan with the rock, a pretty good option as well. Won't get the floater to go. Patronis couldn't put that one away.
Almost coming up with that rebound.
He sure wanted it. Rado Banco over to Richardson. 3 minutes and change remain. In the corner, Rado Banco. Good for three.
Yeah, it might be a case of too little too late here. I imagine the Hawks are going to be pretty conservative here with these next few offensive possessions.
Patronis not taking your advice. He'll go hard to the rim and it'll lip out. Richardson back away, guarded by Noel Bailey. Whole lot of contact there as Richardson going to pick up the foul.
Going to get some substitutions here for Humber as trying to put the finishing touches on this lead. On this game.
Look at that. Last shot made for Niagara. Give them some credit. These Hawks came here to play tonight and they've really kept it a fairly tight game throughout. Got a little bit away from them late in the third quarter.
They know it's on the line. Go for their 12th win in a row. Finally this week, the Hawks got back on that CCAA national rankings, back at number 11. They hadn't been on there since week one when they opened up at number 10. Definitely nice to see them back up there.
Right back where I'm sure they feel they belong.
Absolutely. This is one of the best programs in the country. They should be in that top 10 every week.
Absolutely, especially with those CCAA national championships coming right here at home. The Hawks certainly want to put their best foot forward. Rock gets away from the Hawks there. Kaskar has to trail all the way back to go get it. Kaskar taking a whole lot. And the foul will be on number 7 in white. And if you want to know how Kaskar feels, that face says it all. Samson Towney doesn't look too pleased either. I'm sure they'll be pretty happy in about 2.5 minutes if they're able to close out this victory.
Game got a little closer, though. A little closer than I'm sure they would have liked.
Lead is 13. Niagara has forever stayed in that rear view mirror, not letting this game get too out of hand. Here's Rado Banco. Reverse layup won't drop, and he can't beat Cy Samuel for the rebound. But Jordan Francis knocks that one away from Cy. You can see the frustration on his face.
Yeah, nothing's worse than when you're battling with your own teammate for that rebound and both you guys lose it.
Yeah, gotta respect the hustle.
Oh, absolutely.
Inbound.
The hearts were in the right place. No one's gonna disagree with that.
So a funny looking inbound deflects off a couple of players. As Fousey readjusts the trunks there. Not our first wardrobe malfunction tonight.
It's been a few of those.
Kaskar makes a move, floats that one up there, and that is good. Right on his defensive assignment he goes.
22 points on the night for him, wow.
Kaskar comes to play night in and night out. A long three for Richardson, sure doesn't miss by much.
And he's been dangerous.
Here's Kevin O'Toole going coast to coast, he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line with 1:39 left.
That lead back up to 15 now. Chance here to extend it even further.
The Hawks hit the century mark once again. This offense has really been clicking as of late. Kevin O'Toole, a big part of that.
No points on the board for him yet tonight, though. Even though he has been a big part of this team tonight.
Yeah, he had a run earlier this season. Kevin O'Toole had a run where he scored double digits in 9 games straight. So that's just another piece for Samson Downey. Another tool in the box. So if you've seen any action from the Hawks this season, you know depth is a strength. As John Raven buries that one. Kaskar on his backside, he'll have the inbound. Looking for help from the ref, won't get it. And that'll be a technical foul charged there to Daquan Kaskar. saying a little too much to the referee there. Cascart going to make his way to the locker room with 80 seconds remaining. And he's a guy that's going to show emotion every game, part of his game plan. That's a reason why he's so good, but it also could get you in a little bit of foul trouble.
Yeah, you got to be careful about that lip service you give to the referee.
So Reese Radobanko hits the free shot. Referee wants the shot clock at 21. Trying to figure out if it's white or blue ball. Will be Humber basketball. Jordan Francis inbounds here to Fauzi Muhammad. Near side Samuel, inside Kevin O2 off the front part of the rim. Here come the Knights. Out of bounds the call there as appears Wint stepped out. 20 on the shot clock, inbound incoming from Connor Jolliffe. Radobanko from deep. That one's good. Sharp shooting, Reese Radobanko. All of a sudden, it's a 10-point game here. Long outlet pass to Fauzi. Cy Samuel down on the baseline, guarded by Raven, trying to work in, reverse layup, won't drop. Here's a look now for the Knights. How about that defense by Jordan Francis, but he'll pick up the foul. Cannot believe it. He thought he got all ball there. So we take a look at that last scoring play by Reese Radobanko.
Yeah, deep three, made that one look effortless. And cut the lead down to 10.
Yeah, when you trail pretty big, it seems as though Radobanko is a pretty good shooter beyond the arc. Surprised we didn't see him a little bit earlier in this game.
Yeah, that's a good point, Adam. Guess save the best for last, right?
Not a bad idea.
Maybe not the soundest logic when it comes to basketball strategy, but maybe it's working a little bit here.
In the final minute here, 103-94, Hawks ahead. Cy Samuel going to try to get to the dirty area, finding Justice Salmon, and he's good for two.
A lot of contact there as a couple players went down, Cy Samuels and Connor Jolliffe.
It's been a physical ball game, wide open look for Wintz, and he'll make good. Don't look now, but it's an 8-point ball game as Niagara Knights have really come on here in the fourth quarter. Fauzi just going to slow things down here, set the pace, set the tempo.
And Niagara can't even resort to fouling here because they only have one, so won't result in automatic free throws.
Fauzi thinking about pulling up. Instead, just going to dribble out the clock here. So with all that time wasted, it'll leave nothing but 1.4 seconds on the clock.
I think it's pretty safe to say this game is over.
Everybody rises to their feet. Radobanko won't even worry about the shot. Great game by Olo here. Another great game by Jalen Morgan. Everybody getting involved. Another good effort, 105-97. Your final four as the Humber Hawks get it done, running that win streak to 12. And really, what's the ceiling for this team, Andrew?
National championship.
You better believe it. That's the right answer, my man. So another strong performance by these Humber Hawks, and Jalen Morgan coming up in a big way. Raheem Barty and Richardson on the other side had a heck of a game as well. But the Hawks, just a little too much tonight.
Yeah, really, that second quarter was where they really pulled away and made that lead too big, too much to handle for those Niagara Knights. They made a close game at the end, but just in case it's too little, too late.
It took the Hawks until OT last time out against this Niagara Knights team to beat them. They get it done in regulation tonight as Keith Laria gets player of the game, and why not? With he was kind of the lightning rod for this team here tonight. Really exciting player to watch. And as I go to bed tonight, I'm going to be thinking about that slam.
I think a lot of us here will be thinking about that slam. Just dirty, filthy, disrespectful.
So
any other adjective you could use. I'm throwing it out there. I loved it.
I think you covered them all. So it looks as though everybody in the navy and yellow going to go home happy tonight. as we'll get a nice team photo with the Bell Let's Talk banner. Boys putting on the blue toques, showing their support for mental health. A nice look at the team there as they celebrate their 12th win in a row. That's going to do it for us, Adam and Andrew. Let's throw it over to Caitlin Jones with your post-game interview.
Last week, you won against Mohawk, and you scored more than 40 points in a game. Tonight, you scored 26. How do you make this feel?
It feels amazing. I mean, once again, we all battle team effort, play for each other. Even though we didn't want to finish how we wanted to finish, we still got the dub, listened to the coaches.
12 consecutive win in a row. What has been the cause of most of your success?
Just working hard and being selfless. When we're selfless, a lot of good things happen. Playing for each other always, and like anything else, just working hard every day.
And how are you going to try and keep this win streak going on in your last few games of the season?
It's a good question. We're going to keep staying resilient, not look at the opponent, just keep playing hard, and just play for each other like always, yeah.
Congratulations on your victory. Thank you. Back to Adam and Andrew.
Thanks a lot, Caitlin. Thanks for not leaving Jalen hanging on that last attempt. That's going to do it from us. It's been a fun night inside the Hawks' nest for Adam Lucher and Andrew Milani. Thanks for tuning in to the Hawks Sports Network.